Hi Aquarius, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website at www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Aquarians, it's a fairly exciting and an important month as we have the equinox that is there on 22nd of September. That is not just speaking about changing of seasons, but it is also speaking about change that needs to be brought into our lives. It's a time of a month where there's a lot of mutable energy that is there at play, and we have the mutable signs are Virgo, Gemini, Sagittarius and Pisces, and they are all speaking about going with the flow. They're asking about embracing the change. They are also speaking about making space for new things in your life and letting go of the old. Don't sort of, even though you don't tend to Aquarians, but whether they're the past hurts, old wounds, things that have not worked, you just have to drop them and you have to make space, create space for something new. We're beginning the month with the first 5 days as a Mercury retrograde, and we all know the drill over here. Not a great time to be buying electronics, not a great time to be sending random SMSs or WhatsApp messages, or even sending emails without checking and rechecking them a couple of times. Not a great time to be picking up a new job, new negotiations. And also not a great time to be spending money on a big ticket item. However, it's a wonderful time to be reworking, revising, retweaking your plans that you may have been working on earlier. It's a wonderful time for research. So take the first 5 days before you really launch something, before you start something, and just see whether you have enough information. Do you require something more? Is there some detail that you're missing out on? On the 6th, we have Mercury that is going direct in your house of marriage and partnership, business partnership as well. And it really speaks about also a very harmonious relationship with your business partner that you may be having. There could be a lot of conversations, ideating, a lot of exchange of harmonious energy that could be there. You could be feeling quite in sync with your partners, and you could be agreeing on a lot of things. It's a wonderful energy to create newer things. In fact, it encourages growth more faster when you have partners with whom your energy syncs very well. And then on the 10th, we have Mercury that is moving into your house of joint finances, resources, sexuality and transformation. And now they are good. The conversations get little intense. So if there have been issues as far as your intimacy or sexuality are concerned, maybe it's a time to be having that sensitive topic with your partner. Try not to, Aquarians, sort of ignore things in relationship. A lot of times we tend to take things for granted and we look at intimacy and sexuality as, you know, it's all right, it's there, okay, maybe, you know, no one is running anywhere. But I think this is where we tend to sort of get lazy and fall off, because intimacy is a very, very integral part of a good relationship, as is your sexual energy. So try to keep that live, have a conversation, take time out for your partner, go out, spend some quality time, you know, just the two of you, and just have a lovely, lovely time. And I think it's also a good time to be reaching out. If you are sort of even apprehensive, or even if given up and saying it doesn't matter to me, still try and rekindle it. It's extremely important, because those conversations can be very smooth. It will be reciprocated. We have a full moon on the 6th as well. It is moving into your house of earned income and self-worth. And it can be that a project has come to an end. Maybe in some cases that you finished doing a job, now you've moved on to another job. In certain cases, you're finishing, putting final touches onto a project before you move on to the other. There could just be this sense of completion, fruition. For some of you, you could have just finished launching something and you have that sense of achievement, oh, I just finished doing this, before you move on to something else. In very few cases, if it's depending on your chart as to how it's aspected, it can be that there could be a loss of job, but otherwise it really speaks about finishing off projects. Now Mars also on the 6th moves to your house of your sexuality and shared resources, and there can be some amount of a stress on the partner's income as well. Maybe you could be looking at either this time your partner gets a boost in his income, or you're having to depend a lot on your partner's income, and it could just be making you slightly uncomfortable as far as finances are concerned. In certain cases, few cases, there could be this sense of grudge as well, you know, that I'm having to constantly ask. I'm not making that much of money. Why is it that I have to ask for that money, or why is it that it is not shared with me willingly? On the 20th, we have a new moon that is there in your house of joint finances, sexuality and transformation, and it is joined by Venus. So a lovely time on the 20th. I think it's a lovely time to be, it gives you a new opportunity to have these difficult conversations. It's creating a supportive planetary environment for you, wherein that you could be heard in the right sense. A lot of times when we are saying things, we are sharing with our partners, and we just get lost in translation. We are saying something and they're hearing something, and we're trying to explain, and the further we explain, the further it gets into one spin ball, and we just keep wondering by the end of the conversation, what did I say? I mean, what did I even say which led to this? This is not what I meant. So use the new moon energy where it gives you an opportunity to, maybe it's a time wherein your partner's finances get enhanced. Maybe there's a new opportunity for you to speak about your intimacy, or you can rekindle it. It gives you a new opportunity. It brings about that excitement, that adventure in your love life. On the 23rd, we have Sun that is moving to your house of expansion of the mind and international travel, and it's speaking about either some of you could be dealing with offices, foreign offices, or maybe collaborating, or you could just be understanding, you know, that how the similar product or work that you're doing over here in your country, how it is that similar solutions or challenges are dealt with in international markets. So you could be expanding your mind with more knowledge. It's also a time of wonderful time to travel. So if you can take some time off, so do go out and travel, Aquarians. Overall, a month of free flowing. It's a month to be taking a leap of faith. And take that risk, Aquarians. I mean, you're fairly brave-hearted, and you never know what the universe is going to be throwing back at you. It could be a new direction, a new career. It could be a new love life. It could be an absolutely new life for you as well. So take a risk and go ahead and see as to what the change is going to bring for you. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Aquarians. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.